HA is an acid. Okay, when it ionizes, it gives us an H positive and a B negative. Okay, so this is the first kind of definition for an acid. Acid is anything which releases H plus ions.
Okay,
or if it is in the aqueous medium, when it is dissolved in water, when it is dissolved in water, it gives us an H3O positive and an A negative. Here, A negative. Okay, so again, if there is a presence of H3O positive, it is an acid. Okay. Now, the next kind of acid, the next kind of an acid ka classification would be, is it an organic acid or a mineral acid? Okay. Organic acids, you know, what will the organic acids be? We have done the organic chemistry. Methanoic acid.
Compounds that contain carbon atoms.
Exactly. Ethanoic acid that is present in vinegar. Then we had the propionic acid, okay? And then we have the acid in the milk that is known as lactic acid. Then we have the acid present in the tomatoes that is known as oxalic acid. And then we have the acid present in oranges and all that is known as the citric acid, okay? So all these are organic acids. And the mineral acids are H2SO4, sulfuric acid, H2SO3, sulfurous acid, H2CO3, carbonic acid, okay? And then HNO3 is our nitric acid, H3PO4 is the phosphoric acid, HCl is the hydrochloric acid. So these are all mineral acids, okay? Up, let's go to another type of classification. Strong acids and weak acids. Okay, I'll just switch off my video. Now, strong acids and weak acids. Strong acids are the ones that completely ionize with ionize itself, and weak acids are the ones that do not completely ionize. Basically, iska matlab kya hua? HA, when in the presence of water, are going to give us H positive and A negative. But a weak acid, HA, will give us what? Not this arrow, it will be a reversible arrow. It will give us an H positive and an A negative. Meaning, out here, the products at the end products, what are the end products if we talk about? The end products in this case will just be H positive and A negative. But out here, the end products will be HA also, H positive and A negative. यानी कि यहाँ पे कंप्लीट डिसोसिएशन हो रहा है एंड यहाँ पे वी आर गेटिंग एन इनकम्प्लीट डिसोसिएशन. सो व्हेन देयर इज अ कंप्लीट डिसोसिएशन इट इज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग एसिड एंड व्हेन देयर इज एन इनकम्प्लीट डिसोसिएशन इट इज अ वीक एसिड. ऑल्सो द हाइड्रोजन आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन आउट हियर विल बी हाई एंड आउट हियर द हाइड्रोजन आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन विल बी लो. ठीक है. Now, if we look at it, we have again one more categorization of an acid is, acids are either hydra acids, okay, or they are oxo acids. Now, if we look at the example of HCl, H is directly in contact with Cl, so it is a hydra acid, HBr. It is in direct contact with Br, so it is a hydra acid. But an oxo acid is something like a sulfuric acid. In sulfuric acid, if you look at the structure, this is the structure of sulfuric acid. The hydrogen is attached to the oxygen rather than sulfur. Okay? And nitric acid also the same thing. In nitric acid, we have our hydrogen attached to the oxygen. Okay. Phosphoric acid also the same thing. In phosphoric acid also the hydrogen is attached to the oxygen. So these are known as oxo acids. Okay. Now according to the number of hydrogen ions they release, they are known as मोनोबेसिक एसिड, डाइबेसिक एसिड और अ ट्राइबेसिक एसिड. जनरली हमारे सिलेबस में इतना ही आता है. देर इज ऑल्सो वन मोर, दैट इज अ टेट्रा. नाउ HCl is a monobasic acid because it is going to release only one H plus. But H2SO4 could first release one H plus with an HSO4 negative, and then HSO4 negative could release another H plus to give us SO42 negative. Now, if we combine both the reactions, then H2SO4 can actually release two H positives and SO42 negative. So it is releasing two hydrogens. That means it is a dibasic acid. Matlab, it can neutralize two moles of a base. Now, if you look at a tribasic, the best example is a phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid gives what? It releases one H plus and H2PO4 one negative. Now H2PO4 one negative can lose one hydrogen and it can become HPO4 negative. HPO4 negative can release one more hydrogen to become PO4 3 negative.
Okay.
ठीक है. तो इसका मतलब basically phosphoric acid has the ability to lose three hydrogen ions and a phosphate. So that is why it is known as a tribasic acid. ठीक है. Now, one more definition of acid is what? I'm writing it out here in red. Okay? Anything that is an electron acceptor. Anything that is an electron acceptor is an acid.
Okay.
ठीक है. Now let's come to a base. Now a base generally is written in the form of BOH. BOH in the aqueous medium can give us B positive and OH negative. ठीक है. So when it liberates hydroxide ions, it is a base. Now, apart from the base, there is another definition of a base, which I talked about the acid. The other definition for a base is, it is an electron donor. Like ammonia does not have OH, but it has a lone pair of electrons which it can donate. Okay. Metal oxides are basic in nature. ठीक है. मेटल ऑक्साइड लाइक लेट्स से Na2O, व्हेन Na2O व्हेन इट इज रिएक्टेड विद वाटर इट गिव्स अस एन NaOH प्लस हाइड्रोजन गैस. ठीक है. एसिड प्लस बेस गिव्स अस, ओके ठीक है. सो हाँ ठीक है. ओके ठीक है. सो आपके पास ये क्या आ गया? दिस इज आवर बेसिक ऑक्साइड. ठीक है. Now again, इसमें भी आपका क्या होएगा? You will have a strong base and a weak base. अब इसमें ऑर्गेनिक और इनऑर्गेनिक नहीं होता. ठीक है. Strong and a weak. Again, a strong base shows complete ionization. Okay, and a weak base shows incomplete ionization. तो ये ऐसे हो जाएगा. Okay. For example, अगर NaOH है तो NaOH completely ionizes to give us Na positive and OH negative, and NH4OH अगर है तो NH4OH gives us incomplete ionization, so NH4 positive and OH negative. ठीक है. तो यहाँ पे हाइड्रोक्साइड का concentration will be higher. यहाँ पे हाइड्रोक्साइड का कॉन्सेंट्रेशन वुड बी लोअर. ऑल्सो यहाँ पे द एंड प्रोडक्ट्स लाइक वी टॉक्ड इन द इन टर्म्स ऑफ एन एसिड, द एंड प्रोडक्ट्स आउट हियर वुड बी ओनली Na पॉजिटिव एंड OH नेगेटिव, बट आउट हियर द एंड प्रोडक्ट्स वुड बी NH4OH, NH4 पॉजिटिव एज वेल एज OH नेगेटिव. Now, why did it happen like this? Because the reaction is reversible. Reversible reaction ka matlab kya hota hai? It can go in the forward direction as well as the backward direction.
Backward direction.
Now, after the strong acid and the weak acid, okay, isme bhi hamara kya ho jayega? Monoacidic, diacidic, okay? So, isme bhi mono aa jayega, di aa jayega, tri aa jayega. For example, NaOH can liberate one Na positive and one OH negative. ठीक है, but CaOH hold twice. In the first case, can give out only one hydroxide ion. Okay. And then in the second case, it again releases the other one also, and becomes Ca2 positive and one more OH negative. So basically, what happened is CaOH hold twice gave you a Ca2 positive and a 2OH negative. ठीक है, यहाँ तक clear? Sanika, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
एल्यूमिनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. नाउ इफ यू लुक एट एल्यूमिनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, इट इज ट्राई एसिडिक. ओके, मतलब एल्यूमिनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड कैन फर्स्ट रिलीज ओके वन हाइड्रोक्साइड आयन. सो आपके पास ये हो गया ओके one hydroxide ion, then it can release one more hydroxide ion to become AlOH2 positive and hydroxide ion, and then it can release the third hydroxide ion also, okay, to become Al3 positive and OH negative. Now if you can combine it and write it, it is an AlOH whole thrice giving us an Al3 positive and 3 hydroxide ions. So this is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's look at a salt. Okay. Now, what is a salt? Basically, when you look at an acid, when an acid reacts with a base, it gives us a salt and water. So if you take some examples, okay, आपके पास acid है, let's say HCl plus NaOH, it gives us what? NaCl, okay, plus H2O. So you can get halides. Salts could be in the form of halides. Now halides would be what? Chlorides, bromides, iodides, fluorides, etc. Okay, or if you have an H2SO4 combining with NaOH, it would give you Na2SO4 plus H2O. Abhi, for the time being, I'm not balancing. ठीक है, so यहाँ पे हमें क्या मिला? Sulfate salts. If you take sulfurous acid with an NaOH, giving us Na2SO3. ठीक है, एंड H2O. नाउ दिस इज अ सल्फाइट सॉल्ट, एंड देन यू कुड हैव एन H2CO3 प्लस NaOH गिविंग अस Na2CO3 ओके प्लस H2O. सो इट इज अ कार्बोनेट. सो आवर सॉल्ट्स कैन बी ऑफ मेनी टाइप्स. आवर सॉल्ट्स कैन बी ऑफ यू नो the halides, then the sulfates, bisulfate, okay, halide would be what? Chloride, bromide, iodide, fluoride. Then we could have sulfate salts would be SO4 2 negative. Bisulfate salts would be what? HSO4 1 negative. Okay, sulfite would be an SO3 2 negative. A bisulfite salt would be what? A bisulfite salt would be an HSO3 1 negative. A carbonate okay, would be CO3 2 negative. A bicarbonate or a hydrogen carbonate can also be written as what? HCO3 1 negative. Okay, then you can have nitrate salts. Nitrate salts have what? Nitrate salts have a NO3 1 negative. You could have phosphate salts. Phosphate salts would be what? Aapka PO4 2 negative. Okay, so these are the kinds of salts that you could have. Now, in salts also, we have three types of salts. If you divide the salts could be of three types. One is an acidic salt. One is a basic salt. And one is a neutral salt. Now, as the name suggests, acidic salt will show acidic properties. Basic salt will show basic properties. And neutral salts will show neutral properties. ठीक है मतलब here the pH will be less than 7, here the pH would be greater than 7, and here the pH would be nearly equal to 7. Now when are acidic salts formed? Acidic salts are generally formed when a strong acid combines with a weak base. We get an acidic salt. Basic salt, when do we get? When we combine a weak acid with a strong base, then generally we get a basic salt. Okay, neutral salt, when do we get? When a strong acid combines with a strong base, strong acid plus a strong base, or a weak acid, okay, weak acid with a weak base. Weak base. Okay, so this gives us what? This gives us our neutral salt. Plus, if they have the presence of H plus ions in them, then they are known as acidic salts. So all bisulfates, bisulfites, and bicarbonates are acidic salts. And if the salts have hydroxide ions, then they are known as basic salts. Theek hai? Till here it is clear, beta?